Dear learners, welcome to the course Antennas and Microwave Engineering. In this video, I will be explaining microwave attenuators. What is mean by attenuator? Already we heard about the term attenuator in electronic circuits. Generally, attenuator is used to reduce the amplitude level. It is just opposite to the working of amplifier. This attenuator is generally built up with the help of lumped elements. But here, in the microwave attenuators or waveguide attenuators, waveguide technology is adopted for attenuators. A device which is used to control the amount of microwave power transferred from one point to another on a microwave transmission system is called microwave attenuators. That means it is used to control the flow of microwave power either by reflecting it or by absorbing it. Generally, there are two types of attenuators, fixed attenuator and variable attenuator. Figure 1 represents fixed attenuator. Figure 2 represents variable attenuator. We will discuss these types one by one. The first type is fixed attenuator. In the fixed attenuator, this figure, it illustrates the fixed attenuator. So this is the waveguide fixed attenuator. You observe that here this attenuator consists of a dissipative element called pad, which is placed in a waveguide. This is the power absorbing pad which is placed inside the waveguide. The pad is placed in such a way that its plane is parallel to the electric field. For this, two thin metal rods are used. These two are thin metal rods. Here, these two are metal rods in the real-time example. This is the schematic diagram of the microwave attenuator, fixed attenuator, and this yellow circle point out the power absorbing pad which is placed inside the waveguide. And also you note down, the pad is tapered for producing a gradual transition from the waveguide medium to the absorbing medium of the pad. This also reduces the reflection. So these are the points what we discussed in the previous slide. It consists of a dissipative element called pad which is placed in a waveguide. This dissipative pad absorbs the power flow in the microwave transmission line. In the fixed attenuator, the amount of power absorbed by the attenuator generally depends on various factors. First one is, it depends on strength of dielectric field and location of pad within waveguide and area of pad, frequency of operation, pad material used for power absorption. These factors determine the amount of power absorbed by the attenuator. Next type is variable attenuator. This figure illustrates the variable attenuator. This figure represents the real-time example of the variable attenuator. You observe there is a dissipative pad is placed and an adjustable knob is provided in the waveguide. Here this is the adjustable knob and micrometer is attached here. This variable attenuator provides continuous attenuation. The amount of attenuation introduced is controlled by the depth of insertion of absorbing plate inside the waveguide. So this small video, it illustrates the insertion of the dissipative pad inside the waveguide. You observe here, there is a dissipative pad which is placed inside a waveguide. Once I adjust the knob, there is a change in the depth of insertion of this absorbing pad. It will affect the amount of power flow through the microwave transmission line. In this type of attenuator, we use micrometer which is attached with the resistive film which is placed inside the waveguide. By adjusting the micrometer, we can insert the resistive material and can control the attenuation of the signal. So generally in the waveguide attenuator, we used a flap attenuator which has some resistive or lossy material in the flap. So by setting this flap in the attenuator, we can producing some attenuation. Based upon the depth of insertion, we can produce the attenuation. The lossy material absorbs the energy from the incoming signal. It consists of knob with the help of which we can adjust the attenuation. This is the basics of microwave attenuator. I hope you could understand fixed attenuator and variable attenuator very well. Thank you.